And joining us this morning for our second hot copy, we have Senate President Rosendo So. Good morning to you once again, sir.
Yeah, magandang umaga, Karen.
Magandang umaga. What is your take on the president's quick action regarding the sugar importation?
Yeah, Karen, last week we had just met the president and he told us that the importation is just a second option, and he will see if the local production can produce and prioritize local producers. Nagulat lang kami kasi SRA the other day nag-attend ako dun sa 10 o'clock meeting ng SRA, no? And ang sinasabi lang nila is ito ang presyo ngayon, ito ang distribution, ito yung retail price. So wala silang sinasabi na magpapasok ng 300,000 metric tons, no?
Nagulat ka rin ba doon?
Yes,
sa mga nirmang papeles without the president knowing.
Yes, ang sinasabi lang nila isang short is 100,000 metric tons, no? In which nagsuggest ako na they have to meet the local industry first and call the retailer para alam kung saan nagka-problema yung presyo, kung yung presyo ang pinag-usapan. And in the meeting, they also said that there is an advanced milling. No? Ibig sabihin, yung mga magsasaka, nagdadala na sa milling. No? Nag-advance milling sila, so dinideliver na sa miller. So kung yung kakulangan is end of the month, baka mahabol pa, di ba?
Yeah.
So baka less than 100,000 metric tons ang kailangan. No? So dapat kinausap muna yung local producers, retailer, distributor para at least malaman kung ano ba yung talagang pagkukulang.
Okay. So you've been experienced in this. You've been involved when it comes to agri in different forms. So given the fact that they said we only lack 100,000 metric tons of sugar, and yet they signed 300,000 metric tons, what are you seeing here, Rosendo? Ano to?
We see some corruption, no, within the department. And the volume is so much, three times the volume they are saying that ito yung kulang, pero three times yung ipapasok, no? And last week, the president just tell us that we have to work with the DA to have the statistic, no? Kung tama yung mga statistic na pinipresent. And we are working with DA for the past few days. Like sa port, no? Kung makita mo, bumaba yung presyo, naayos yung volume. So yung susunod na importation, pinag-aayusan, pinag-uusapan. And yung sa chicken, sobrang pumasok din. So kailangan pag-usapan. And dun sa onion din, ganun din. Nandun ang mga magsasaka, nandun yung producers. So kinat yung importation ng kalahati nung nagsuggest yung industry and the farmers, no, about the white onion, no. So dapat ganun ang ginawa, hindi yung basta-basta na mag-i-issue. Na in which pumirma pa under the name of the president, you know, na hindi niya alam. Yun ang pinakamahirap.
Oo. May nakikita ka bang, you said there's possible corruption, but are you also seeing, kumbaga, a possible syndicate behind this? Because we do know in different parts of agriculture, that's been such a challenge, right? Fighting the rice syndicate, the smuggling syndicate when it comes to vegetables. Nakikita mo ba ito, Rosendo?
Yeah, ganun na ang good kasi kung nag-i-issue sila ng permit, doon lumalabas yung smuggled kasabay, no? So dapat bantayan mabuti yun, and we hope na maayos, no? I think the president is very serious kasi yung mga fertilizer importer, pinatawag niya sa Malacanang ng Wednesday eh. He wants the price to be lower, no? Mm-hmm. To help the farmers. Nag-set pa siya ng ano, around 2,200, no? Sa ngayon kasi nasa 2,250 to 2,300. So ibig sabihin talagang gusto niya is ayusin yung sa agriculture, mababa yung presyo, matulungan ang mga farmers, and to dialogue with the local industry. Yeah. Yun ang ginagawa ni Presidente.
So it's clear the President himself is meeting, yes, with the stakeholders, because he's also concurrently Department of Agri, but he's giving this special time and attention. And he's met with you a few times. The last time I spoke with you, you said you met 3 times, so now you've met 4 times.
Yes, in which he was very concerned of our local production that dropped, no, very much, no. The rice before, yeah, we are 95% self-sufficient. Now we are only 85% self-sufficient.
Okay.
And our hog industry also failed, no? And the chicken industry. So ngayon gusto nila patayin yung sugar naman. So dapat siguro ang direction ng ating yung mga tao dun sa loob ng DA, yung gusto ni Presidente. They have to follow what the President wants.
Okay, just very quickly, balikan natin ang sugar. To be fair, the Sugar Regulatory Administrator, Mr. Serafica, said he was looking for 300,000 metric tons because he said the country's sugar stockpile has already been depleted. Those were his words. So they needed, he claims, we need to import sugar from Thailand, Vietnam, Malaysia, and Indonesia. So ang tanong ko ngayon, are we able to locally produce? I mean, the sugar bowl of the Philippines, is it still able to produce the needs in terms of at least maybe 90% of the country's sugar needs?
Yeah, as he presented to us, he said around 100,000 metric tons ang shortfall. No? And if that is so, if the miller is already accepting from our farmers to mill, baka less than 100 na lang yan, no? And if they can the farmers can give that to our miller, maybe they can plant again, no? Pwedeng mangyari yan. So dapat siguro ang pinakamaganda, Karen, is kausapin ang local producers.
Oo.
Kung ilan, okay, bang talagang kaya and ilan ang balanse, yun lang ipasok para at least hindi naman malugi ang ating local producers.
The Sugar Regulatory the Sugar Regulatory Board has used Typhoon Odette as one of the reasons that it claims the sugar production has been affected. Do you feel our agencies are coming up with effective responses? Because we are a country that's struck with more than 10 typhoons a year. So the reasoning is, mahirap na dahilan naman to kasi lagi tayong binabagyo, di ba?
Yeah.
So ang tanong ko, are we coming up with effective responses, Rosendo? Not only sugar, with rice, with so many other things that can actually affect production.
Yeah, Karen, you're right, no? Sa tingin ko hindi bagyo yung naka-apekto doon sa production. Baka pwede pa yung inputs na fertilizer.
Okay.
Nabawasan yung paggamit, yun pwede. Kasi yung typhoon naman yearly tumatama sa atin eh.
Yes.
So hindi yung problem, no, ang nakikita natin na bumaba yung production. Maybe high cost of fertilizer. Kasi worldwide ito na other countries, ganun din ang problema. So yun, yung reasoning nila mukhang hindi rin ganun katama.
Oo. And Rosendo, what do you think is the reason why we aren't able to control our prices? Because the SRP of white sugar at one point was at 50 pesos a kilo when international prices were half its price. Bakit tayo ganun? What are we doing wrong?
Yeah. Other countries subsidize their farmers very much compared dito sa countries natin, and ang budget compared to other countries like Thailand, they are giving around 10%, no, to their farmers, no? Of the national budget. Tayo dito around 2%. So talagang dehado tayo sa compared to other countries. So ang cost of production natin dito siyempre mas mataas. Pero nakikita rin natin yung import is also going up, no? Kasi gumagamit din sila ng input, so sinasubsidize lang ng government. So to protect our farmers, hindi naman kasi yung importation, nakita ko, sinabi nila mataas din eh. So wala na yung 50 pesos, no? Nasa 70 pesos to 80 pesos din ang tinitingin nila dun sa importation. So malapit dun sa local production natin. So kung ganun lang ang diferensya, dapat tulungan ang mga magsasaka natin para at least ang ating local producers para mag-produce ng mas marami. Diba?
Because it turns out importing isn't cheaper from buying it locally. So my last question with you is, do you believe that, of course, an investigation is ongoing? Malacanang has said it will determine if heads should roll or will roll. But given that his signature was apparently in that document and the president denied that he signed it, what do you make of that, sir? Should the Sugar Regulatory Board, frankly speaking, be replaced?
Yeah. Karen, tayo na lang, no? Ordinary tayong tao. Eh tayo, pangalan natin, kung pinamahal na hindi natin alam eh, talagang pwede natin idemanda yung nasa, yung tao na pumirma. Ito pa is our president, di ba? And they signed it na hindi niya, wala siyang knowledge. So, malaking problema yan kung hindi niya tinanggal yung mga tao nito.
All right. On that note, thank you so much, Rosendo, for joining me today. I do hope to speak with you again.
Thank you, Karen. Maraming salamat.